Good day to you from ChemHelp ASAP. Let's see the basics of cationic polymerizations. On the screen is an alkene. This alkene is not remarkably electron rich, but it does have two methyl groups, which are weak electron donating groups. This alkene is called isobutylene, or 2-methylpropene. For cationic polymerization, we need to make a cation. An easy way to make a cation from an alkene is to add a strong acid. I have chosen sulfuric acid. The alkene will be protonated by the acid to form a carbocation. I'm going to move my methyl groups up top. There's our carbocation. The carbocation is stabilized through hyperconjugation by our 2-methyl groups. It is a tertiary carbocation. While tertiary carbocations are stable relative to other carbocations, it's still a carbocation and highly reactive. The carbocation can then be attacked by another isobutylene monomer. That gives us another new cation intermediate. This process continues until we eventually get a polymer. Polyisobutylene. This polymer has formed through the addition reaction of cationic intermediates. It is a cationic polymerization. For a cationic polymerization, you need the monomer to form a somewhat stable cation intermediate. That happens if you have at least one EDGR group on your alkene. In this example, we have two EDGs, two methyls, but one is often adequate. Classic EDGR groups for these sorts of alkenes include ethers, OR, amines, NR2, esters, it's an oxygen with a carbonyl, and amides, an NR group attached to a carbonyl. This is the general mechanism for cationic polymerization. A strong acid often initiates the polymerization through protonation of an electron-rich alkene.